I'm super excited about this one because this is Bumblebot. This one is really good. Oh my gosh, look, oh, it's a small pretty. I love it. The greeting cards also arrived, but I made a bit of a mistake. As you can see, it's slightly off-center for the sweetie one, and I ordered 100. It's totally my fault for not proofing the design. This is the inside. It's still really, really cute, so I'm still gonna sell it, but I'm gonna sell it as a second. So just a word of warning, make sure everything's central before you send it off for print. But this is the sweetie design. It looks quite cute, doesn't it? It's still cute, it's just off-center. And it's a buttery velvet finish, so we got the marshmallow one, and then this one's not off center, but it's our new Valentine's one, or just general love one, of ginger and spice and the little balloons with them floating away. Then we've got this one, which is your berry lovely, and then the final one we got in is ginger and spice again, which is a remake of an old Netflix one that we had. But it says this time, all the little moments make the best memories when I'm with you. It's really cute. And then it just says, I love you so much on the inside. And I added these little love hearts, so they've arrived as well. And the back just has our details on. Can you see? Hello guys, and welcome to another studio vlog. So it's been such a weird morning this morning. There's been so many things that have gone wrong and so many things that have gone right. So it's just been a total mix of emotions this morning. I'll get into what's gone wrong first. We came in, the heating is still broke and it's snowing outside, and there's like a storm, kind of like a snowstorm hitting the northeast of the UK at the minute. And yeah, it's very, very, very cold. So everyone's in coats and wearing coats and everything while they're wrapping up. I'm lucky because this room is really small, so it holds the heating really well. I've got a little space heater, but we're trying to heat up the inside of the room out there with space heaters and radiators. And then one of our fuses has blown in the sockets because obviously we're overloading it trying to heat up this room, so we had to contact the reception, and that's the one where all the heat presses are plugged in, so we've totally probably overloaded the extension leads. Just absolutely crazy. There's a lot going on. And then to top things off, Mike, bless him, cut his finger open on the paper dispenser. It just was all going wrong. But then we got the final delivery of beanies that arrived, and I'm so freaking excited with how these have turned out. The quality is so, so nice on the stitching. It's always worrying unboxing like the first products you get. Someone asked me if I get samples, and I've only ever received picture samples of these and not actual samples. Anyway, the beanies have arrived and I'm super, super excited. So in this vlog, I'm going to launch these beanies for the first time. So there's going to be a lot of photography going on, and also I want to create my own branded tags for these. So I'm actually thinking of having separate tags for each one. So the frog on bear logo, a little cute strawberry logo. So really excited about that. So that's going to be my first port of call. I don't want to wait for these any longer because it's the middle of February, it's snowing. I want to get these out to you guys as soon as possible because it's very wintry and very cold. I don't know if you guys noticed, but Studio Ghibli visuals is playing behind me, and this is like the best thing. I have it on all the time. It's kind of like a screensaver because it's so pretty. HBO Max, because now Studio Ghibli is over there, even though we can't get it here in the UK, they have put up on their YouTube channel just 30 minutes of beautiful Studio Ghibli scenes. Chef's kiss. And they put like noises like on it, like nice seagull noises and wind noises and train noises depending on the scene, and it is so perfect. I literally have this on all the time. And also, just before we get into working day, shout out to Emma from Fox and Cactus for sending me these beautiful earrings. They're so nice, perfect for Valentine's week. Thank you so much, Emma. I love them so much. So yeah, let's get into the working day, shall we? I feel like I've rambled for ages. I wanted to hang a plant, so I just used this command hook. I got this fake plant from Amazon. I think they're called pythos. I'm actually gonna get a real one for home. I can't have real plants in here because there's no natural light. But it's starting to look more and more like a cottage. I love it. Back, I've got care instructions, and I've just stuck it together using spray mount, so like a spray glue. I'm just going to see what it looks like against the hats because I don't want to order these and they're not be very nice. I want to make sure the branding looks nice. Got a little hole punch. I'm gonna do a little experiment. Why isn't that cutting? I think I might actually round the corner of these, so I think they'll look cute. No idea how to use this. I think we slot these in like that. Slot this in. Wait. Oh. I can't do it. It's so fiddly. Alright, okay, I think I've done it. Then I'm gonna try and find the existing hole. Well, I want it on top. Too big.
Make sure not to poke yourself. And we're going to squeeze down the trigger. And the tag just popped right through with the needle. Let go of the trigger. And slowly.
Why can't I do it? Okay, so I've experimented with the packaging for the tags. I had a nightmare with the tagging gun, I don't know why. It's pretty simple to use. I was just being an idiot, I think, but I think I've figured it out. I just YouTubed it and watched a couple of tutorials, so figured that out. The only thing I would say is that the tags are a little long. I should have got barbs that were, I think these are quite long. I think these are 50mm barbs. Or tags, whatever you call them, but I think they're called barbs. So I've actually ordered some short ones so that it's a little shorter, so they're not like dangling all the way down. But the problem is they're not going to arrive by Friday, and I plan to launch these on Thursday, so I'm just going to keep the short barbs in stock. I'm going to use all of these barbs for now and then keep the short barbs in stock for when I do another batch. But this is pretty much what they look like. I'm stupid because the hole punch is too big, so they just actually fall out. But this is only a test. Can you see it just fell out? But this is what the back looks like. I did some care instructions, but the beanies inside do have the care instructions anyway. Yeah, this is what they look like. I'm happy with how they've turned out, so I'm gonna send them off to get printed at my local printer so we can get them fast. And I'll probably spend a few days tagging them, but I have got some bags for these to go in. So I actually got some frosted compostable bags that I'm going to try out and see what they're like. So they're like frosted like this. And they're like, yeah, they're like to put clothes in and stuff. And as you can see, they're compostable. And it says that they're compostable along the back there. So I don't know whether I'm going to give the option for these so that they don't get water damaged, or whether I'm just going to pack them all in it, ready to go. But I think I might give the customer the option of removing these if they don't want to have any packaging. But this will protect them in the post to make sure that they don't get water damaged. That's what the finished piece will look like. And I was thinking of having a sticker on the front of this these frosted bags, but I felt because these are compostable and biodegradable, I felt like if I put the stickers on top, I don't know how that would change the compostability of these bags, so I didn't want to risk it. So instead you can just kind of see the designs and the tags through it. So Yay, they look really cute. Good morning. So yesterday, my friend Rachel actually came round and we took some photography shots of like the hats and stuff. So we had a little photo shoot session. I think I might try and take some myself, but I'm not very photogenic. So I don't know, I'm not the best person for photographs. Yeah, Dean has just been to the local printers and picked up the labels. It's so good having like a local printer. And this morning I actually spent the morning writing my book that I've been writing. But look, we've got some labels for the hats and beanies. So I'm going to corner cut all of these labels and unbox them, make sure they're okay. And then I'm going to corner cut all these cards and I'm going to list these as soon as possible, hopefully by the end of the day. So I'm going to round all these corners and take some product photography and list them. I'm so sorry about the noise that's going to happen in the back of these vlogs. The aircon is still off, so it's always going to be like a heater running. It's super toasty and warm in the cafe, but it's really, really cold in the studio. Luckily, this is why my nose is sniffing, but why I've got a really sniffly nose. But yeah, if you can hear the background noise, I'm very sorry about that, but there's nothing much I can do without freezing my tits off. This is the current situation in the studio. We got given an industrial heater from receptionist to try and warm up the place. It's better than nothing. Yeah, I should have been behind. I've got loads of satsumas, I can't melt heads. I literally can't get these out. We need some better solutions for storage because these take up a whole of the space. We need some sort of sliding roller system so we can put like the pads in, like, do you know what I mean? In squares like this and not take up too much space. I'm just making a tag for them with some, it's not gonna look cute, but it'll do for now. So my task today is to tag a load of the beanies. The small little tabs came, which looks so much nicer, so I'm literally going to be spending all day doing this. So this is what the new beanies look like with the smaller tag. It just works out a lot nicer because it's like the same as the Beachfield one. Editing Catherine here. So I'm just editing the end of the studio vlog and I did a whole section chatting to you guys, but I literally had the most horrendous bogey up my nose. I didn't even look in the mirror before I started filming and I thought nobody has time to look at me looking like that. So I'm actually just signing off the vlog right now. I hope you enjoyed it. Put a little cat or a beanie emoji. Try and put some sort of hat emoji in the comments if you made it to the end. It's always funny to see everyone's interpretation just to celebrate the beanie. Beanies being launched. This studio vlog is a little bit late, so I'm so sorry about that, but I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so freaking much for watching. I'll see you all very freaking soon. All right then, thanks so much for watching. I hope I don't have a bogey this time. I love you. Goodbye.